That's good. Save something. Yeah.
It's better how
you, you'll win this. I didn't get a caller. No. Hello, Bob.
Where are you going? I'm surrendering. You're sitting in your neighborhood.
That's good.
Thank you for coming down. I know the question, or the situation that brings you here, and I feel so strongly about this. I can't understand anyone being reluctant about the federal government having what virtually all of our states have, and that is a proviso against what we've had for, 48 out of 50 years, and that is an unbalanced budget. So what is the situation?
Well, we got a good, Dennis Deacon-Sini couldn't be here, but we have a good bipartisan base.
Good.
We need 67 votes, and it's, it's very tough. We could put somewhere between 63 and 68.
Right? 63 to 4.
Yeah.
But I know a few that I call. I don't understand it. I can't understand some of the gentlemen I call who are opposed can continue to think that there's something wrong about adding this proviso to the Constitution. Thomas Jefferson asked for it back when the Constitution was ratified. Said it was the only glaring omission. There was no prohibition against the federal government.
What do you think, Strom? I've got Hatfield, JT. You got a pretty good head coming in, Paul.
Yeah.
Let me say this. I just want to say, if you can get this thing passed, there will be no better accomplishment in your administration than this. And next is, there will be no step we can take that will ensure a Republican majority in the Senate for this.
That's not Paul.
I'm not going to turn him off, but I know how you feel, of course. I know what you want, but...
You want some people on the right side there?
If we could.
Ma'am, would you like to come around to the other side, sir? Right.
Another man. Yes, wonderful to meet you. My mother's a great admirer, but I think you're a little liberal sometimes.
He doesn't
know his
mother's practice. Did you ever know a child who understood his parent?
Never.
Thank you.
The parent understands the child.
I'm a great admirer of his and all that he's done. We'll be seeing in a few weeks.
Yes.
We'll be there.
We're very excited. There is a great good fortune in the world that you and your arms are very, very
thank you very much. Wait 1 second. We don't want you to forget us. So, there's a pair of cufflinks.
Oh, thank you.
The seal. This is a bookmark.
Thank you.
Then there are two younger people here. And inside here is a jar with the seal engraved on it. And inside are jelly beans.
Oh.
And because somebody will tell me you can't open it till you get home or something, if you really want to try a sample, this is what's in the, this is what's in the jar.
Thank you, Mr. President.
All right. Well, you're moving up. Good luck.
Thank you. And thanks. Still working for you. Look forward to continuing.
And thank you for everything.
Thank you, sir. For being president.
Thank you for being
president. Yeah, I like just
I'm sorry to have kept you waiting. Usually I'm behind schedule before this. Hello there. Welcome. How do you do?
It's Fred Whipple.
Glad to see you. Good to see you. Well, please, be seated.
Hi, Ed Stone.
Nice to see
you. Since it's a working lunch, that means we can talk with our mouths full.
Mr. President, as you know, this is our fourth luncheon where we brought in scientists from various disciplines to let you know where they're at and what they see as the future in the next several years. For the benefit of our guests, we had one on robotics and computers. Then we had one on space in terms of the general exploration of it, what man was going to do in it. And then we had one on medicine, which turned out to be a whole discussion with the whole
Uranus or Uranus.
Uranus. And we thought the president ought to know what's being discovered out there and what it means and what it looks like. And with that, why don't I turn it over to Professor Whitmore?
Could I just ask one question here? I forgot the word that you said. I listened to all of the anchors on television at the time when that spacecraft was going out there. All my life, I've called it Uranus, and I heard them saying it was Uranus.
Uranus. That's what we all call it, Uranus.
Uranus?
Yes.
Ah. Okay.
From now on, it's
Uranus. I think some of them were saying Uranus, though.
Oh, Uranus.
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 Okay. All right.
But we always call it.
Well, if I'm good. Discuss the comet. There is the close-up picture made by Giotto, and over on your left there you see that dark object, and that is a part of the nucleus which is in silhouette against the background lighting, the dust light of the comet. And we were very fortunate in that because the USSR, the Vegas, went in and they saw only the jets, and they had no picture at all of the nucleus itself. Just good luck that less dust and also a better system that the Giotto people had. The signatures there are the four Americans who were members of the imaging team that made the photograph. So we have their signatures.
Well, thank you.
Greg, you were surprised at how large the nucleus was, right?
Yes, it was about 1.5 times larger, and it's very black. That was our. It's blacker than almost anything you can pick.
Charcoal black.
Charcoal, at least, black velvet. It's made up of extremely fine particles, about 100,000th of an inch in diameter and less. Finest powder with a lot of carbon in it. So there's just nothing blacker you can find anywhere. It's amazing.
But then that isn't a solid thing like our planet or anything.
No, but it's full of ice. It's about 50% or 70% ice. And this is the model that I postulated back in 1950. We had a lot of confirmation of that. That formed way out, we think, in the outermost.
Mr. President.
How are you?
Fine, thanks. I can meet my son, Adam, sir.
Oh, there.
And that's Alexandra.
Hi,
my daughter.
How are you?
Oh, my goodness. I cleared that.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
By the way, thank you. It's
nice to see you.
Well, Mr. President, I appreciated your offer to provide a reception, but I think you and I have been to enough of those. In lieu of that, I'd ask if you would kindly meet with my staff, because these are the people who have been so supportive of me, in addition to my family, of course.
Well, I will. So let us have a family.
Oh, I'd love that.
First.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Right. Now,
yes, just so you won't forget us.
Thank you, sir.
You're going to have to read a book. It's a book.
Thank you.
Thank you very
much. And in here is a jar, and it is filled with jelly beans. The two of you.
Thank
you. And of course, your parents probably won't let you open that before you get home in case you're curious about what the garden is like.
Thank you.
And Sam. That's the first thing.
Thank you, sir.
Well, thank you.
His friend Danny McCaffrey. Dan McCaffrey is over there. He's an FBI agent who is now doing the liaison work for the bureau over in London.
Yeah.
And they were big buddies.
Well.
He said, same.
Okay, pal. Well, we'll tell him you remembered.
Absolutely.
Yes, you will.
Thank you for my list.
Mr. President.
Yes.
Dick Osner. David Lawler.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Everybody's moving out here.
Yep, they're all moving out, sir.
John Roberts, sir.
See?
Debbie Owen.
Hello.
Very nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Anna Holland's been my assistant for 5.5 years. She deserves every credit, too. Jane Dananauer has run your security office for 5.5 years.
It's a pleasure to see you.
My secretary, Mary Beth Bakke.
Hi.
Hello there.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Another secretary, Mary Larson.
Thank you.
Well, I thank you all and everything. You're going to feel pretty bad when, like, tomorrow night, you find out I'm in jail.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
Mr.
And here we go.
Ladies,
these are just little souvenirs. You're going to have to have keys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you.
So I do one big group photo here. One day. What do you got?
If you could pull up just a little bit. Yeah. There we go.
They're all through.
That looks good. Big smile. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I noticed I got the earliest Easter card. What do you call the jelly beans that get left in the bottom of your Easter basket because they're a flavor you don't like? Has beans.
As the other one says, I can't stand it. Thank you, sir.
Well,
thank you. 2:30.
Yes. All right. Okay. Goodbye.
Good, sir.
What are we going to do for movies?
Well, we got a replacement already for you.
Oh, all right.
Hello. This is my wife, Gwyneth.
Nice to see you.
This is my daughter.
Yeah, Paula.
Nice to meet you.
Do you think we ought to have a family picture here?
Of course.
Yes, all right.
Thank you, sir.
Well, I want to thank you very much for all that you've done.
Well, Mr.
President, we haven't given you too many impossible tasks.
No, no, I'm sorry we didn't have better movies to give you. That's the big thing.
The Golden Oldies all with me.
Oh, they're the best.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
These are just some souvenirs so you won't forget us. This is a bookmark.
Well, thank you.
And a key ring.
Oh,
see?
Thank you.
And thank you. Thank you all.
You're welcome, Mr. President.
All right. One thing about the movies running off there, Camp David, I'm convinced we did make them better in the old days.
They changed them so much.
I said, I came home, I sit back and watch the old ones better than the new ones. Yeah.
Paul, if we want to see King's Row or the winning team, we can still get them, can't we?
Oh, yeah, yeah, no problem.
And these weekends,
no problem.
We got to do that.
It might take us
some
couple weeks.
To request it. I feel too self-conscious.
I'll request it for you. Before I leave, that will be my last request.
All right.
All right.
And thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My pleasure, sir.
I'll see you tomorrow. Now it's around, isn't it?
Yes.
Hello, Mr. President.
Hello.
It's good to see you, sir.
It's good to see you.
May I present my wife again?
Very nice.
Ralph.
Very nice.
It's nice of you to have a practice interview
around here.
Thank you, sir.
Well.
Thank you,
Paige. Well, it's good to see you and I have a couple of souvenirs so you won't forget us.
Oh.
Thank you. May I look at the man's present
book
now?
Well. Oh, sure. It's a great book now.
How charming. Thank you so much.
That's nice.
Yes, lovely.
Mr. President, I hope you're keeping good health after your ordeal last year. I'm keeping it good health after my ordeal. And I pray for you, and I know you pray for us. And, Glad to have known you. I'll see you at the White House Correspondents' Dinner next month, April the 17th. I think you're going, aren't you?
Well, I don't know the schedule.
April 17th. You're doing a drop.
I knew it was there, but there seemed to be, when I first brought it up, there seemed to be some question as to whether my schedule was going to remain.
Well, we hope so. We hope so. Okay. Thank you again. Very much. All the best. Lovely night.
Thank you, Mr. President. You'll have a chance to Mrs. Wade.
I sure will.
Chaz is shooting for Reuters. He'd like to get a picture of just you and Ralph.
Oh.
That's okay. No.
Maybe it's pretty good pictures. I really am.
Oh.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yeah, God bless. God bless you.
Thank you again.
Aryan gas and created a comet. The satellite is taking the pictures. Right here. You know, what are comets made of? Here it is, a man-made comet in space, and it forms into it, and the tail begins to form. And of course, it doesn't last too long, but it was fascinating hearing about these things. And here's a shot of it, too, the artificial comet. Touch of Star Wars there. Those are the rings around the Venus. And they must be new rings, they said, because these faint ones, this means that the stuff that forms the rings has not quite gotten together yet, like these other more positive ones.
We're ready now, Mr. President.
And that's Uranus. That's the South Pole, and the reason that, like our South Pole, and the reason that it looks that way is because there, instead of the poles being upright, the poles are crossways, and that one's facing the sun all the time. It goes around the sun, with the pole being...
That's my grandson, Mr. President.
Well,
this is the grandson.
Let him have a seat. He won't see anything while he's in here except that. Why don't you come in here and why don't we get a family picture?
Okay.
Thank you.
Does the old man want to come in now for part of the picture?
Might as well. He's a granddaddy now.
When I get a hair real set. You're good.
Thank you.
Great.
Thank you.
Well, now wait 1 second here.
Justin, you see the person? No, look at that.
You have a bookmark for a souvenir.
Thank you.
You have a key ring for a souvenir with a seal on it. And this one gets a jar with the seal engraved on it. The jar is filled with jelly beans. And in case before it gets home, you can try them out. If you wanted to try one without unwrapping the box yet, there's
thank
a sample
you.
Of what's inside.
Thank
I'll
you.
I'll let you carry that.
Justin, can you say thank you?
Can you shake his hand? Say thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Can you say thank you, Jeff?
Say thank you. No. You see what he goes for. Thank
okay.
you.
Great.
Thank
nice
you.
Thanks
nice
a lot.
To see you.